Yes. Okay, I'm here to talk a few minutes about the Nixos Wiki. I'll try to stay below 3 minutes to get you to lunch. So, most of you probably know the story about the Nixos Wikis, more than one. We had the old official wiki that was basically put in read-only mode some time ago. Then there was a short discussion on GitHub, what to do with it. Most of you probably participated in that. Yeah, some people started the Nixos users wiki on GitHub. To be honest, I really dislike the GitHub wiki style and I did not want to use it because it felt not like a wiki that I want to use. Then we had this incident event, like the links were completely removed from the website and people were looking for the old read-only wiki and it was basically gone. And then I started the new Nixos wiki, the unofficial one, as kind of replacement. Yes, there's a detailed history available in the wiki itself. So some figures I will present to you, just to provide you some background. There's basically no logging on the wiki, so we don't have proper numbers. They're all taken from the Google Webmaster Tools, because that's the only source of numbers I had available. They were always representing a range of 3 months before I extracted them. So I want to give you an impression with that what is often looked at in the wiki. Those are the top queries leading to the wiki. Apparently Nixos and Docker is an interesting thing and people like to game on Nixos with Steam. So other stuff like ZFS, Raspberry Pi and so on, you can see the list yourself. So those might be topics that we might want to expand on in the future on the Nixos wiki because many people are looking at it. Some graph showing how often the Nixos wiki is shown in Google search results, like in 3 months, nearly 350,000 times. It's displayed only 28,000 clicks. So, but there seems to be some interest in the Nixos wiki or whatever is written in it. The top pages of the wiki, of course, the cheat sheet. Then we have something that's a bit odd, like some pages have way more expressions than are appropriate for the number of clicks. But those might be pages we want to work on, especially the FAQ, the create and debug packages. Perhaps we should even think about extending the official documentation, especially around the package creation, if people are looking it up in the wiki instead of the documentation. So that's one thing to think about. Countries from the visitors, United States, Germany, France, are on the top of the list. So but we are quite an international crowd. The registered users on the wiki, so there's a steady growth. Keep registering, keep adding content. Some technical information, it's hosted on a small VPS at Vulture. It's managed via NixOps, everything except the MediaWiki part that is being worked on. If anybody wants to help long-term with that, not just like a one-off thing, please talk to me. People that fear the content might be lost someday, there's a daily dump you can download. Some people already do it, like every night. And for the future, it's planned to put a CDN in front of the wiki to make it faster outside of Europe. Yes, and that's it. Thanks to all the wiki contributors.